Good morning, St. Mary students. Welcome back to STEM. I have really missed your beautiful faces and sweet smiles. And guess what? I went out and bought some more of our Create a Burger sequencing kits. I know that you guys love these. Everybody wants to play with these when we're in STEM lab. So I bought some more and hopefully I'll see you soon. Today what we're going to do, I'm just going to remind you of the Build a Burger process that we use in STEM. Remember, you look at an order card and then you put the burger together the way that the card says. Like for example, in this card, you start out, you have your bottom bun, then you have your burger, and for those of you who don't eat meat, you can also use garden burgers. But this is a beef patty. And then it looks like, what is that? That green thing there. I think it's lettuce. So we put our lettuce on next. And remember, it's very important during this time of being careful about germs and eating well to eat our vegetables. So we put our lettuce on next. And then what it looks like, an onion. Now, onions can make you have bad breath, so you want to talk to your parents, since you're all cooped up together, about using too many onions. But there's our onion. And then this red thing, I think, is a tomato. So we'll put that on next. And then the next thing, and some of you have called these cucumbers, and I think it's awesome that you know what a cucumber is. And I think these are pickles, but they're actually made from cucumbers. So this is our pickle. And then we come back to the top and put our bun on. So this is our sequencing for order number 6. And remember, sequencing is a reading ability, but it's also order and patterns, which is also a math learning skill. So, I don't know about you, but I really can't eat a burger without cheese. So, I'm going to change our burger and put the cheese on top, although it usually goes on the bottom. I don't know why that is, but here's our burger that we built for today. And by the way, how do you like my hat? I borrowed it from my husband. So, there's our Build-A-Burger. And we'll be hopefully back to school at some point, and I'll see you smiling when you build your burgers. But I don't know how many of you would make a burger at home. If your mom is cooking a burger at night, I would suggest you go in and just try to help her with putting the burger together. But you have to make sure to wash your hands really well. So before you do this activity that I'm gonna share with you, you want to make sure you wash your hands really, really well, 20 seconds, hot water, soap, and then don't eat what I'm showing you, okay? We're playing with food, which we normally don't do, but I'm going to show you how to build something called a shish kebab, a fruit shish kebab. And I'm using a shish kebab tool, but I would not suggest you use it because it's very sharp on the end. So ask your parents if they have like a stick or something that you can use to build your shish kebab. And again, we're playing with food and we're not gonna eat this food. So we're going to build a fruit shish kebab out of fresh fruit, and we're going to build our sequence for the shish kebab in our ABC order. So, when you think about fruit that starts with an A, I hope you're thinking at home with me, what's the first thing that comes to your mind? An apple. So I have an apple that I've cut, and I'm going to stick it on my shish kebab, and it's gonna go to the bottom, because we're gonna build from the bottom up of our shish kebab. So the next thing, I would think A, B. Okay, well, there's berries, but I think I want to be more specific about what kind of berry it is. A, B, banana. So I'm gonna use a banana next. I'm gonna put the banana piece on my fruit shish kebab, starting from the bottom up. A for apple, B for banana. Okay, so C, I don't know if there's any fruit. D, E, let's see what I have here. Oh, I know. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, grape. These grapes are kind of small, but they'll fit on my shish kebab. So I have G for grape. Okay, L, M, N, O, P. Oh, okay, so I'm gonna go up to an O, and I'm gonna use an orange slice. And oranges are really great sources of vitamin C. So try to make sure you're eating lots of fruit. So I have my orange, A for apple, B for banana. Then I skip some letters, G for grape, O for orange. So now I'm gonna go back to some berries. And this is a raspberry. And so I'm gonna put it on next. So raspberry, R for raspberry in my sequence of ABC order. And last, I have a very big, juicy strawberry. So I'm gonna put that on last. See, we built a fruit shish kebab. So try this at home if your parents are okay with it. They have to give you the approval. And do not eat the fruit after you play with it. But we have built a beautiful and healthy fruit shish kebab. So I'm praying for all of you to have a safe and healthy Easter, and I can't wait to see your beautiful faces and sweet smiles again someday soon. Take care from STEM Lab.